Hello everyone, Arun Van Gopal of WNYC here. It's my pleasure to introduce the Center for Traditional Music and Dance's series, Beat of the Boroughs, NYC Online. This online series features over 50 of New York's leading traditional instrumentalists, dancers, singers, poets, and more. From Mongolia to Haiti, Colombia to the Gambia, among many others, they remind us how the strength of our country lies in its embrace of diversity and immigration. We want to celebrate these remarkable members of the New York community in these challenging times. So please enjoy these 50 programs, share them with your friends, and spread the word. Enjoy the show.
My name is Martha Zarate Alvarez. So we are friends with Mariachi Real de Mexico, and I work in a company that is called Mazarte Dance Company. And we always work together, you know? Music and dance, they always together. They work perfectly together, right? So then we always have this engagement and community and passion for what we do with the Mariachi Real. Move around if we want. Front and back. Front, back, front, together and front, back, front. One more time. Back, front, together, front, back, front, together and. Last time. Okay, we're gonna go to the Gulf of Mexico, to the state of Veracruz. And Veracruz also has a lot of influence from other countries, especially Africa, Spain, of course, and pretty much Spanish and Portuguese, they brought all the people from Africa and also from that Morocco and that part of Africa. And the fusion in Veracruz is very special because the singing, the melody, the instruments, everything takes you to those places. So, and we use a lot of footwork. So for this kind of music, we're gonna do a song that is called El Colas. And we're gonna learn a very easy pattern. And I guess everybody knows what café means, right? Can anybody say what café means? Café? Somebody can say café? Okay, I think we know.
Coffee.
Yeah, of course, coffee, right? Okay, so coffee. So we're gonna do a step that it says, it's called café. So we're gonna do café, 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 café. Café, 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 café. Then we're gonna add café, café, café fast. So we're gonna do slow, slow, fast, fast, fast. Right? So, café, 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 café. Start with the other side. Café, 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 café. Café, 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 café. Café, 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 café. Okay? So that's the rhythm, café. So it's morning, so we need some coffee. So there you go. We're going to have a lot of coffee now. Okay. So we do that when it's just instruments playing. When there's, mostly when there's the voice singing, when they sing the verse, then we just do descansos. And descansos, we just gonna do one, one, two, up, 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 one, two, up. And then the third one, we just do café con pan. We're gonna start pan, which pan is bread, with café with bread. Okay, we're gonna do pan, café con pan, café con pan, coffee with bread, coffee with bread. Café con pan, double, single, single, double, single, single, double, single, single. And then we can move with flavor. Okay, and so these are the three steps we're gonna do. Café, 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 café. Then we're gonna do the descansos. And then we're gonna do café con pan, café con pan. Okay, so let's listen to the music. And the song name is El Colas. Pan, pan, café con pan. Café con pan, café con pan, café con pan, café con pan. Café con pan, café con pan. Café, 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 con pan, café con pan, pan, café con pan.
Café, 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 café. Como yo que te quiero y no puedo tener. Si quieres, puedes.
del Colas. And we drink so much coffee this morning. So we do like double, right? Right? But in reality, you know, this type of music is based on you know, we make music by things that we say normally, like cafe and pan and all that. So it's basically following the rhythm. So even if your cafe is different than my cafe and it sounds the same, then it's okay. So as much as you follow the rhythm, so then it's fine to do it, right? And then same thing with the cafe con pan. But in that, it gives you a little bit more to move the body and join your upper body as well, not just your foot, but the upper body. Because you can do it very soft. It's like very similar to the rhythm we do when we dance salsa, for example. Is that the same thing? See? So it's very sickly, the same thing. And you see this type of rhythm in all over the islands, Cuba, Puerto Rico, and all the Caribbean islands. You see this Cuban rhythm or African rhythm that is the café con pan.
Amada Magdalena, tú eres Nicolás. Quería que yo comiera tamales de Alcatraz. Amada Magdalena, tú eres Nicolás. Quería que yo comiera tamales de Alcatraz.
Colás, Colás, Colás de Nicolás.
You did with your hands, and you feel free and awesome, beautiful. That was very, very beautiful. So I think now it's more clear, right? The two influences, the two different influences that we had in the north part of Mexico and the Gulf of Mexico. You know, you can see, and you keep listening and to listen and more of those rhythms, you're gonna find more similarities to the European and African and Afro-Caribbean rhythms, which is, you know, it's very important. We all together, we are all one, you know, music connect us. And you wanna see where this thread is coming from, keep listening to this music and then this music, and it's gonna tell you to places that you never hear before. And then, you know, you can start, you know, learning a lot. So here on the heel and on the tip, we use, they put the tiny needles in to make the noise, and also the heels are made up of wood. So it's wood, needles, and needles. And the sound is different as a tap shoes. I don't know, it's still very noisy, but then the sound is different, right? You know, we consider an instrument. So this is the instrument that dancers use, because we, the musicians sometimes, you know, they relate on the tap work, right? And yeah, it is. Okay, so, well, I'm gonna wrap this up. We're gonna say goodbye. I'm very happy and humbled to be part of this event. Thank you so much to all the participants. You did a great job. I hope you really enjoy, and I hope you keep enjoying the rest of your day with this program. It's gonna be awesome. This is just the beginning, and I hope to see you next time. Okay, thank you so much.
Buenos dias, hola amigos, ¿cómo están? How is everybody doing? My name is Ramon Ponce. I am director of Mariachi Real de México here in New York City. I started when I was just 16 years old, and this is our 30th anniversary. And I'm also director of the Mariachi Academy of New York, which is a nonprofit that we started back in 2002 to keep our traditions and music alive here in New York City. And it's an honor for me to be here with you, to share this beautiful tradition, this beautiful music, and talk a little bit about where everything came from and how it started, and also how we continue to promote and to keep alive this beautiful tradition of mariachi music, which I'm sure many of you know or have seen someplace around your area. First, I'm going to talk briefly about the history of mariachi music, where it comes from, where it all started, and how it came about. Mariachi music dates back to the 1800s in Mexico, and it starts in central Mexico, which is now the states of Jalisco, Colima, and Michoacán. And as you know, and Marta was talking earlier today about the different types of music that we Mexicans have. If you go through the different regions in Mexico, we have different music, different types of music, but somehow mariachi music became Mexico's music, and it's the one that people know all over the world. Even though we have up in the north, we have banda and norteño music, which they use a lot of accordion, and then we have traditional banda, which is like all wooden instruments and wind instruments. And then we also have in Mexico marimba down south, and we also have música veracruzana, which is from the state of Veracruz. But as I said, mariachi music just became known worldwide, and it became Mexico's music. And I'm very happy and honored to be part of this wonderful family of musicians that we do mariachi music here in New York City and around the area. So it's an honor again for me to share this beautiful tradition. And I'm also going to talk about briefly about what we wear, you know, because everybody has questions as to where the mariachi outfit comes from and how this came about. So I'm going to talk about, you know, what we usually wear as mariachi musicians. We have the traditional ankle boots. They're just small botines. We call them botines, and then we wear the traditional pants with the buttons on the side. I don't know if you can see this, but this has a lot of detail, and the buttons are made of different materials. In our case, we use sterling silver, And this is just like a piece of jewelry on our pants, you know, literally, because they're made, everything is handmade and everything is custom made. For us, like the botines and the hats and things like that, they come from Guadalajara, Jalisco, which is where mariachi music comes from. And also the mariachi suit, el traje de charro, how we call it. We have our tailor that it's been doing our suits for the last 30 years, and he's from Mexico City. And we wear the traditional pants with the gala. This is called gala or botonadura. And it's just the buttons that we put on the side. And these are actually sewn onto the pants. Every time we have to clean the pants or the suit, we get to take them out. You know, we pull the string, and we pull this out of the pants, and then we take it to the cleaners. And then when we get it back, we have to sew it back on. So it takes about an hour to get the suit ready. But it's a beautiful piece of art, really. And then we wear what is called the, you know, we have a big belt with a big buckle. And this is usually from made out of pita. And we also wear a vest and the traditional mariachi jacket with the brooches, you know, with the brooch. And we also have a beautiful hand embroidered bow tie. You know, it usually has different patterns or different things on it, and we have our name. And of course, the beautiful hat. You know, this is just part of the outfit that everybody knows and everybody wants to see and wants to wear. And everything, as I said, is custom made, and this happens to be hand embroidered. And then they put it on the hat. And this one is called a Cocula style hat from the state of Jalisco. So this is our traditional outfit, the traditional mariachi outfit, the things that we wear in order for us to look like mariachis, you know, like we're gonna play music. And I'm also gonna introduce a little bit about the instruments that we use, because these are not just any regular instruments that we use. For mariachi music especially, we use this one. This little tiny guitar. This one is called vihuela, and this is actually a Portuguese instrument that dates back to the 1500s, but we in Mexico gave it a twist, and now we use it as part of the mariachi ensemble. As Marta was saying earlier today, we have a lot of influence from Europe, and mariachi music is just a direct influence from the Spanish. You know, we have of course the guitars. Even the outfit comes from a version of the traditional matador, and you know, because it looks very very similar, we have to wear not as tight, but we wear a tight suit. So that it looks, you know, with the broad shoulders, and it looks really really like a version of the Spanish matador. So the instruments do the same thing. You know, we use this particular instrument. It's called vihuela, and this one has a little hump in the back. You know, it's got a, and that's what it gives the instrument its big sound. Because remember that mariachi music, it's usually acoustic. You know, we don't have any microphones. When you go back to Plaza Garibaldi in Mexico City or any plaza in around the world, usually musicians stand there and we play and sing acoustically without any amplification, any microphones. That's why our instruments have to carry out, and also our voices, we usually have to sing out because, remember, we usually have 12 people, you know, 10, 12 people back in the band, and we have to be able to sing out, and we have to be able to stay on top of the trumpets, the violins, and the vihuela, and all the instruments. So we use this particular instrument called vihuela, and this is the rhythm section of the mariachi band. And along with that, along with the vihuela, we use this one. and this is a piece of art. This is called the guitarrón. And this is really the heart of the mariachi band. You know, this is what you hear when you hear a live mariachi band or a recording. This is the bass of the mariachi band. And this particular instrument is custom made in Guadalajara, Jalisco, in Mexico, by a great Mexican luthier. His name is Roberto Morales. He recently passed away. And there have been a lot of great instrument makers throughout the times and even now. But Roberto Morales was the one who's been making mariachi instruments for over 50 years. And so the sound of the instruments are the ones that you hear all over the recordings and everything, because these beautiful instruments are made there for the last 50 years. And again, this one has a back shape. I don't know if you can see it, but it looks like a little boat, almost. And this is a 6-string bass guitar, and we play 2 strings at the same time, which is very unusual for instruments to happen, because what we want is to have a big sound in mariachi, and the only way to have that is by playing 2 strings at the same time. So. So it gives it a lot of depth, and it also gives it a lot of volume, because if we only do 1 string, it almost sounds like an upright bass. But when you play the 2nd string, that's when you get the big sound, the big guitarrón sound, and you get this beautiful sound along with the vihuela and the regular guitar. So that gives it the rhythm to the mariachi section. And then when it comes to the melody part, we usually have just a regular B-flat trumpet, you know, like the ones used everywhere. My father is a trumpet player. He's been playing for 60 years mariachi music. And we also use traditional violins, and we use also a harp as part of the ensemble. So you can check out our channel. You will see performances of ours at Lincoln Center and all these great venues with the whole band. You can just go to our YouTube channel, Real de Mexico, or follow us on Instagram, and you'll see a lot of our performances and things with the whole band. But basically, this is what we use. This is what we perform with. And again, it's just such an honor for me to share all this with all of you today. I want to thank everyone for being there, for listening to me. And I'm going to do a little bit of music, of course, because we want to sing and play something. I'm going to do a few songs from different parts of Mexico so that you can listen to the different types of music that we play within the mariachi genre, because even though it's one group, we can play almost anything because of the instruments that we have in ensemble. We're able to do any types of rhythm, even rhythms that come from another country have been adapted to the mariachi music, because it's very easy for us to play almost anything, literally. And you can see on YouTube mariachi bands that play, you know, even rock and roll and even, you know, different types of things, because we have the guitarrón, we have the bass, we have the vihuela, which is the rhythm section, and of course we have the trumpets and the violins. So it gives us a lot of opportunities and a lot of things that we can do and we can play. So I'm going to stay within the mariachi tradition and what we do in Mexico and the different type songs that we perform. And I'm going to go back and sit. And the first piece I'm going to do is actually called Serenata Huasteca, which is from a great, great Mexican songwriter. One of the best, if not the best, José Alfredo Jiménez. If you like mariachi music, you really have to listen to this wonderful artist. I can say that almost all of his songs are just hits and just part of the mariachi tradition because he's so big and you know, songs like El Rey, Si Nos Dejan, and all these beautiful pieces are his. So I'm going to do Serenata Huasteca by the great José Alfredo Jiménez.
Canto al pie de tu ventana, pa' que sepas que te quiero. Tú a mí no me quieres más. Pero yo por ti me muero. Dicen que ando muy errado, que despierte de mi sueño, pero se han equivocado, porque yo he de ser tu dueño. ¿Qué voy a hacer si de veras te quiero? Ya te adoré, olvidarte no puedo. Dicen que pa' conseguir una fortuna, que debo bajar del cielo las estrellas y la luna. Yo no bajaré la luna ni las estrellas tampoco, y aunque no tenga fortuna me querrás poquito a poco. ¿Qué voy a hacer si de veras te quiero? Ya te adoré, olvidarte no puedo. Sé que hay muchas mujeres y que sobra quien me guíe, pero ninguna me importa, solo pienso en ti, morena. Mi corazón te ha escogido y llorar no quiero verlo, y el pobre mucho ha sufrido, ahora tienes que quererlo. ¿Qué voy a hacer si de veras te quiero? Ya te adoré, olvidarte
Gracias, gracias. Thank you all very much. That is a traditional huapango alegre, and this particular song is from the great José Alfredo Jiménez. There are different types of as I said, of songs that we do in within Mexico. You know, earlier today they did a polka with the dancing part of it. And they use a lot of the accordion and you know, the drums, and when they go down to like to the southern part of Mexico, we even do boleros and we even do traditional jarocho music, which later on I'm going to do. So we have different types of music, and every type of music is performed a little bit different from the other one. Because they come from different places and they have different backgrounds. So this other song that I'm going to do is just a traditional Mexican song, which I'm sure you know because we sing it all the time and everybody knows it. It's called Cielito Lindo. And I would like for you to sing along because I know you danced a little bit earlier today. But I want you to sing as well, and I know you know the music, and I know you know the song, so feel free to sing. It's called Cielito Lindo, and this is a traditional, we call it ranchera, a traditional song form that, for those who know music, it's like a waltzy version. You know, we do one, two, three, one, two, three, the bass goes one, two, three, one, two. So depending on the different types of ranchera, we can either play it soft, but if we have a ranchera that, you know, that's very meaningful and that's very deep, you know, and that's saying, you know, because remember, mariachi music talks about feelings. My father always says that if you have something hurting, you know, just let us know, we have a song for that. Because mariachi music comes from the heart. In order for us to sing something or to perform something and to really express ourselves. We have to feel the music. We have to feel the lyrics. The lyrics talk about love, talk about despair, talk about love, about everything, you know, that life has. And so we have to interpret the music that same way with our instruments. If it's something about love, you know, we have to play our instruments very soft because we want it to feel that way. But if it's something, you know, like you have in your heart and you want to say it out loud, you know, you have to make your instrument feel that way so that you can really feel the music. And even though you don't understand the lyrics, you can still feel and you can still know what the music is about. Because you can feel what the song is saying through our music. So for this particular song, this is a very famous song and a very popular song, and I want you to sing along with me. This one is called Cielito Lindo, and then I'm going to do something a little different so that you can see the difference. Sing along, okay?
De la Sierra Morena, cielito lindo vienen bajando. Un par de ojitos negros, cielito lindo de contrabando.
And then we do it again.
De la Sierra Morena, cielito lindo vienen bajando. Un par de ojitos negros, cielito lindo de contrabando.
And then we all sing the ay 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 part.
Ay 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 ay, canta y no llores, porque cantando se alegran, cielito lindo, los corazones. Ese lunar que tienes, cielito lindo junto a la boca, no se lo des a nadie, cielito lindo que a mí me toca. Ese lunar que tienes, cielito lindo junto a la boca, no se lo des a nadie, cielito lindo que a mí me toca.
Everybody, we're gonna do the ay 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 part again. Here we go.
Ay 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 ay, canta y no llores, porque cantando se alegran, cielito lindo, los corazones.
I'm going to go back a little bit and talk about how this came about. The traditional band started back in the late 1800s. It only had strings. Actually, the guitarrón didn't exist back then because it was the harp that took over the bass line at the very beginning. It was just the harp, the vihuela, the little one that I showed you, and a violin. And they didn't have the trumpets back then. Later on, they added the guitarrón just to give it that bass line to the ensemble. But they still didn't have the trumpets. That was until the 1920s when the jazz era came about, and the mariachi musicians moved to Mexico City from Jalisco, and when they started doing radio shows, they noticed that the melody from the violins doesn't carry as much, especially with the guitarrón and vihuela around. they needed something extra. And so they added the first trumpet back in the 20s, and they saw that it helped a lot when it came to TV or radio performances. And so they kept that one trumpet for some years. And later on, Mariachi Mexico added a second trumpet when they recorded the polkas. You know, they started doing Jesusita in Chihuahua and all these great mariachi polkas. And that's how it came about, and that's how it stayed for many, many, many years, until very recent that mariachis are adding a third trumpet, but this is happening just now. I mean, this is because they wanted to sound more like a little orchestra, I guess. So the arrangements are becoming a little bit bigger. They even have flutes, or they even have cellos or violas within the mariachi ensemble. You can listen to Luis Miguel's recent mariachi album, and you can hear that. Even though it's mariachi music, it really sounds like a little orchestra. That's because they added these additional instruments. They added the additional trumpet and the additional instruments to the mariachi ensemble. But the traditional mariachi group, it's usually 12 people, six violins, and they stand on this side, six violins, two trumpets. So the trumpets and the violins are on the right-hand side of the ensemble. And then right in the middle, the harpist, and then the guitarrón, the bass. And then comes the vihuela right next to the guitarrón, which is the rhythm guitar. And then they have a regular guitar. So it's six violins, two trumpets, the harp, the guitarrón, vihuela, and guitar. That's the traditional mariachi ensemble. Nowadays, they added a third trumpet and they added a second guitar just to give it a little bit more power, you know, and just a little more presence. So I'm gonna do this beautiful song from another great Mexican one. She's Consuelo Velázquez, and this is a beautiful song that I always sing, and I'm gonna do both the English and the Spanish version to this song. It's called Bésame Mucho. They actually recorded this song, I think, in almost all languages, you know, because everybody knows, even the Beatles and all these great musicians have either played or recorded this beautiful song. And again, because, you know, we're celebrating Valentine's Day, I'm going to dedicate this song to all of you by the great Consuelo Velázquez, and this one is called Bésame Mucho. Bésame, bésame mucho, como si fuera esta noche la última. Tengo miedo perderte, perderte después. Bésame, bésame mucho, como si fuera esta noche la última. Miedo perderte, perderte después. Quiero tenerte muy cerca, sentirte en mis brazos, estar junto a ti. Piensa
que tal vez mañana yo ya estaré lejos, muy lejos de ti. Bésame, bésame mucho. Each time I cling to your kiss, I hear music divine. Bésame, bésame mucho. Hold me forever and say that you'll always be mine. This love is something new, my arms enfolding you. Whoever thought I'll be holding you close to me, whispering, it's you I adore. Dearest one, if you should leave me, each little dream would take wing and my life would be through. Bésame, bésame mucho. Tengo miedo perderte, perderte después.
Gracias, gracias. Muchas gracias. That was a beautiful Bésame Mucho by Consuelo Velázquez. And as you can see, you know, it's something that's a little softer. We call it bolero ranchero. And that's how we perform the music, you know, just a little bit with a lot of love. You know, that's what we pretend to share through those particular songs. I think I have time for maybe to do like one more song. So I'm going to go back again to the state of Veracruz to do a little bit of Son Jarocho. And I would like to invite back our dear friend Marta, because she did such an amazing job, you know, and she's just a great dancer. And we're very happy to partner and to be here with you this morning. And we're going to do a little bit of this great song from the state of Veracruz, and this one is called La Bamba. You know, it's usually played with the harp and jaranas, but we're gonna do our version for you this morning. So please welcome back Marta. There we go. And we're going to do a small piece of La Bamba. So sing along. I know you know the verse. I know that you know the chorus. Bamba, 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 bamba. So, you know, just feel free to sing along. And you can also dance along. For those of you who were earlier in the session, you know the steps to this this particular song form. So you're also welcome to dance with us this great song from the state of Veracruz.
Se necesita una poca de gracia, una poca de gracia y otra cosita, y arriba y arriba, arriba y arriba y arriba iré. Yo no soy marinero, yo no soy marinero, por ti seré, por ti seré, por ti seré. Everybody, bamba, 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 subir al cielo se necesita una escalera grande y otra chiquita, y arriba y arriba, arriba y arriba y arriba iré. Yo no soy marinero, yo no soy marinero, soy capitán, soy capitán, soy capitán. Bam, 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 bam. Qué bonita es la bamba. Qué bonita es la bamba en la madrugada cuando todos la bailan, cuando todos la bailan en la enramada. Y arriba y arriba, arriba y arriba y arriba iré. Yo no soy marinero, yo no soy marinero, soy capitán, soy capitán, soy capitán. Bam, 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 everybody, come on. Bam, 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 bam. Ay, Cupido, te pido. Ay, Cupido, te pido de corazón que se acabe la bamba, que se acabe la bamba y venga otro son. Allá arriba y arriba, arriba y arriba y arriba iré. Yo no soy marinero, yo no soy marinero. Por ti seré, por ti seré, por ti seré. Bamba, bamba, bamba. Sí, señor. Gracias, thank you, Marta. Muchas gracias, Marta. Thank you all very much. I want to thank the Center for Traditional Music and Dance for being part of what we do. We had the Mariachi Academy of New York, which is a nonprofit, as I mentioned, where we give free music lessons in mariachi music, and I'm very proud to say that we are the only ones in the whole country that offers free music lessons in mariachi music here in New York City. And I want to thank them, and I want to thank the Fleury Festival for having us here today, and for us to be able to share a little bit of what we do, a little bit about our traditions, our culture, and music, and dance through this medium. I know it's a little different today because we're usually, you know, around people, and we invite them to dance, and we invite them to sing, but everything has to be a little bit farther away these times. But it's okay because we're still able to come across and to share what we love doing, which is music and dance. And thank you again for giving us the opportunity to do so. And this year, as I mentioned in the beginning, Mariachi Real de Mexico, which is the band my father and I started 30 years ago, are having our 30th anniversary, and as part of the celebration, we will have different things throughout the year going on. So check out our website, mariachirealdemexico.com. Go to our Instagram page at Real de Mexico, and like it, and visit our YouTube channel at Real de Mexico, and there you'll see performances of the band and the different things that we're going to do throughout the year. Hopefully ending, if God permits and if everything goes well, ending with a performance at Carnegie Hall again this year for our 30th anniversary. So you're all invited to join us, to follow us. And once again, thank you all very much for your time and for allowing us to share our music with all of you. Muchas gracias. Thank you very much.